Greetings everyone. In this video, I am going to show you four SSD M2 disks that I am using in my daily life for AI tasks. I am going to compare their speed and I am going to make benchmarks and experimentation with them. The first disk that I am going to show you is NetHack NVMe SSD 2TB. It is my system drive, so it will be a little bit slower. Also, it is running on PCI X4. 8000 megabytes per second. The second disk is Kioxia Xeria Plus G2 SSD 2TB. This is my newest disk that I have just purchased. You see, it has been used only 53 hours so far. These are its features. It is running on PCI Express 4X slot, but I don't know why it is 4000 megabytes per second. The third disk that I'm going to compare and benchmark is Kingston SNVS2000G drive. It is also running on PCI Express 4X slot and it is 8000 megabytes per second. And the last disk that I am going to test and benchmark is SanDisk Ultra 3D NVMe 1TB disk. Even though it is running on this PCI Express M2 expansion card, it is running with also PCI Express 4X link, so it is 4000 megabytes per second as well. During the tests, the M2 disks will get hot, so to be ensured that there are no throttling due to heating, I am going to temporarily cool them down with this way as you are seeing right now. So you may wonder why I need so many disks. I am doing a lot of AI stuff and I'm going to use this newest disk as a cache folder for Hugging Face AI models. But you can use them for any reason. Also, please subscribe our channel and join our Discord channel. The links will be in the description of the video. My CPU is 13900K. My motherboard is Gigabyte Z690UD. I have submitted my disk information to the CPU Z validator and the link of this validator will be in the description of the video if you want to check it out later. So for testing, I am going to use Crystal Disk Mark, the latest version 8.0.4. I will do the 1GB default testing and I will also do 16GB testing. Moreover, I am going to use this Python file to generate a file with 150GB size. So we will see their performance when writing very big files. Because after a while, the cache of these M2 disks get filled up and their speed decreases significantly. So we will see them how they are performing. Okay, let's begin with our first drive, C drive. I will do 3 times testing, all tests. Currently, the disk is 53 Celsius temperature because there is a 1 big GPU running in my case. The read speed is amazing. Meanwhile, I am recording a video. Let's also see the speed in the task manager. All right, here we can see. Okay, read speed is also displayed here. Currently, it is doing the slower test, 3.3 GB read speed. We can see we can definitely get the values that we should get. During the reading tests, the temperature is not rising, you see, almost same, but when writing it is getting really hot. However, since I am using this technique, it should not get very hard to throttle the disk. Okay, the tests have been completed. Even though this is a system disk, even though it is very much full, you see, it is almost matching the on-sheet speeds. 7000 megabytes per second, the on-the-sheet speed is 7200 megabytes, 6700 megabytes writing, it is almost matching, so it is amazing. Now I will do 16GB test version. So I started another instance. You see, it is running in as administrator mode. I am going to set this as 16GB, I will make it 3. And I will do another test, so we will have a comparison. But amazing, speeds are amazing. All right, the NetHack NV7000 disk tests have been completed. These are the speeds, it is amazing. When we set the test size to 16GB, there is a significant drop in writing speed. This is probably its cache is getting full, and therefore there is a speed decrease. Now I will do the same tests for SanDisk Ultra 3D NVMe, Kingston SNV2S2000G, and also Kioxia Xeria Plus G2 SSD, and I will show you the results immediately and I will comment on them. Okay, all the tests on all disks have been completed. Now let's look at them. The first C drive is our NetHack drive. The second F drive is our SanDisk drive, which was the SanDisk drive. Let's remember it. So here, this is the SanDisk drive. You see the speeds of SanDisk drive is also pretty decent, over 2 gigabytes per second for sequential reading and writing. The third disk is G drive, which is this drive. And G drive is the Kingston drive, as you are seeing the speeds right now. For some reason, it is getting very low writing speed at 16 gigabyte test, as you are seeing here. And the last drive is my newest R drive, which is Kioxia Xcaria Plus G2. You see the speeds are amazing. Other than the NetHack, I think the winner here is the Kioxia Xcaria Plus G2. And now I am going to do massive file writing tests. In that test, we will see how they are performing after a certain amount of data written to the disk. So this test will be hugely important. To do this test, I will make a temporary folder here, temp22. I will move the Python file. Let's start a CMD and type generate file. And here we will watch the writing speed. It is starting. Let's also watch the temperature of the disk. Unfortunately, this disk is running under my RTX 3090 Ti GPU, therefore it is always hotter than it should be. Okay, the writing is going on. As you are seeing, the writing speed is now like 2 gigabytes per second. The temperature is really, really cool right now. There is no issues. There is no drop of the writing speed so far, 2 gigabytes per second. We can also see the file here. Let me show you. Let's click the properties and you see already 80 gigabytes written. Okay, we are getting to complete it. Still 2.3 gigabytes per second. There is no increase in the temperature as well. Okay, 2 gigabytes per second. Wow, you see there is no drop of the writing speed for NetHack. This disk is amazing. And we can see, yes. Okay, 1.1 gigabytes per second. I think there is some drop after at this point and it is done. So for writing 150 gigabytes file, it took 91.48 seconds and 1.64 gigabytes per second on average. But after a while, speed has dropped. You can see it. Let me zoom in. So we can see that it was always almost 2 gigabytes per second. And after a point, it dropped to 1 gigabytes per second, but it didn't drop lower than that. Okay, now I will test the SanDisk Ultra Disk. So I will open a new CMD inside our Python, generate file, and let's see the writing speed. Okay, it is starting. Okay, initial writing speed is 1.2 gigabytes per second, 1.9 gigabytes per second. Okay, it drops quickly to 800 megabytes per second. You can see that. Okay, now it is writing with 875 megabytes per second. This looks like this disk has a very low cache. Therefore, it dropped the speed pretty quickly. So when we are writing a big file, this disk is getting a speed drop very quickly, 872 megabytes per second. And let's check out the temperature. You see the temperature has risen to 48 Celsius. It was like 30 Celsius previously, but it is not a big issue because I think this disk is running normal under 70 Celsius. So it is looking good, 875 megabytes per second. So we can say that this disk has a very minimal cache. After that, you are going to get constantly 873 megabytes per second. So SanDisk Ultra got another speed drop after a while. You see here, it dropped up to 300 megabytes per second and it took 230 seconds to write with average 650 megabytes per second. Okay, now it is time to test Kingston and let's see the speed of the G drive. Okay, it is beginning with the writing speed of, let's see, 1.7 gigabytes per second, 1.9 gigabytes per second. Very good, amazing speed. 2.2 gigabytes, 2.1 gigabytes, then there is a significant drop here, writing speed, 100 megabytes per second. The biggest problem with this disk is that its cache is almost non-existent. So I do not suggest you to purchase this disk ever. You see, after a while, quickly, it became horrendous speed because the cache is filled. Then there was a significant drop in the speed. Then it backs to 2 gigabytes momentarily. Then it drops down to 100 megabytes second again. So this disk is very bad if you are working with large files. Avoid this Kingston SNV2S 2000 G drive. It is still writing with an horrific speed, as you are seeing right now, 80 megabytes per second. The temperature is not rising. Obviously, it is not working very much. Time to time, it increases the speed like this, 700 megabytes per second, and it goes back to 80 megabytes per second. So this disk is definitely terrible. We will see how much time it will take in a moment. All right, the writing has been completed. It took 526 seconds to write the entire file. It was only 290 megabytes per second. So it was a terrible speed for the Kingston SNV2S2000G. Okay, finally, it is time to test my newest drive. So let's begin the testing. All right, the test has begun. Let's see the writing speed. Okay, 1.8 gigabytes per second, 1.9 gigabytes per second, really good. Let's see how much it can keep up, 2.2 gigabytes per second, amazing speed, 2 gigabytes per second, 1.4 gigabytes per second, there is a significant drop here, 1.4 gigabytes per second, okay. After this significant drop, it is still able to keep up 1.4 gigabytes per second. If it can keep up this speed to the entire operation, it will be super fast. Let's see, it is now 45 Celsius. Okay, it is really good temperature. Still 1.4 gigabytes per second, there is no drop. However, you see, other than the NetHack, all of them has a lower cache. The cache of NetHack is amazing. Even though it is running as a system drive, it is still performing very best. After NetHack, looks like Kioxia Xcaria Plus G2 is the second best disk. Still 1.3 gigabytes per second. There is no drop of speed. I hope it can keep up 150 gigabyte file for the entire duration. 1.4 gigabytes per second. Still amazing speed. There is no drop. Okay, I see some drop. Maybe it is getting completed. Yes, it is completed. So it took only 105 seconds and it was 1.42 gigabytes per second. The average speed, it is amazing. Okay, here we see all the disk speeds. The first one, the C drive, is 1.64 gigabytes per second. It is NetHack. It is a system disk, however, still the fastest disk as you are seeing. The second one is 1.42 gigabytes per second. It is Kioxia Xcaria Plus G2. The third disk is my SanDisk drive, SanDisk Ultra 3D, 1 terabyte disk, and its speed is 650 megabytes per second. And the terrible and horrific speed having disk is Kingston SNV2S 2000G disk. It is only 290 megabytes per second. Terrible. Horrific speed. So when you are purchasing an M2 SSD disk, consider all of these factors in your mind and try to purchase a disk which can keep up maximum writing speed for the longest time. So the number one disk is NetHack. Number two disk is Kioxia Xcaria. Number three disk is SanDisk Ultra. And the most terrible disk is Kingston Drive. I hope you have enjoyed. Please join our Discord channel to chat. Moreover, on our channel, we have amazing content. Just click this search icon to search any kind of video. I am producing all kinds of artificial intelligence videos, generative AI videos. I also have full playlists of programming videos. When you go to the playlist, you will see all of our playlist videos. We have so many full playlists, full lectures, also AI videos. Moreover, you can track me on and follow me on GitHub as well. I have a great stable diffusion repository. I will put the link into the description. Please start our repository, fork it, and watch it. I have a lot of tutorials and a lot of useful content I am sharing. You can also subscribe to my Patreon and support me there. You can also subscribe our YouTube channel and support me there. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial video.